Hello everyone, welcome to Mock Duck Plays Games. Doing something a little different today because I know there are quite a few of you out there with original Atari 2600s, quite a few of you with CRT TVs, and quite a few of you out there who would like to take that 2600 and hook it into your computer, whether it be to record video, live stream, capture video footage, or just because you can. And you'll notice on Amazon there are a lot of RCA to HDMI adapters. One solution is to get one of those adapters on Amazon, maybe run your Atari 2600 through an old VCR or other method to turn it into an RCA composite, and then send it in through one of those so that you can bring it in through an Elgato or a similar style capture card to your computer while still being able to send it out through HDMI to a monitor. I've used one for a couple of years now that was kind of one of these Amazon cheapies, and it worked okay. I can talk a little bit about how the one I'm going to be looking at today compares once I've given it a little more time. You'll see it happen live here. But I wanted to just call out that you can get these things pretty cheaply. They do have some downsides, but it might be a pretty good solution for you. So let's take a look at one that is currently Amazon's choice on Amazon.com. And I'll show you an example of the kind of thing you might be interested in. This is the one I am going to be taking a look at today. It maybe has a brand, but not really. It's essentially generic warehouse stuff, the kind you might see on like your Wish or Alibaba or, in this case, Amazon. You can see it's down to $25, which is why I was willing to roll the dice on it. And in particular, the reason I got it is I like that, unlike my last one, it theoretically has a switch for 4:3 aspect ratio, you know, Atari Square aspect ratio, and the widescreen 16:9. So that if I were, say, to try to run my PS2 through it, I could get a 16:9 capture, but then I won't anymore have to resize in XSplit or OBS or something a stretched out image to make it 4:3. So that was kind of nice. The other big feature this one has is it has two inputs that you can swap between. So you could, in my case, I will probably have the VCR through one and my PlayStation 2 on the other side so that I can don't need to unhook it and hook it up every time. However, we'll see if this thing even works. First, the package real quick. I'm not doing an unboxing per se. You can see it's as generic as it comes. They did save the best for me, so that was pretty nice of them. I don't know how they looked at all their boxes and gave me the nicest one, but somehow they did. When you take a look at this little, like I say, about the same size as the last one I had, you know, the size of a pack of cards maybe. Pretty simple stuff. Metal construction, like the last one did too. Not like it made a huge difference, but better than plastic. And it does come with an HDMI cable. I don't know if it's, say, 2.1. It would not surprise me if they did not put one in. And they did specifically say that the USB cable is for charging only. It is not capable of data. And then it just comes with a little nub to plug it into a wall socket if you need to, and a set of basic instructions about how to use it. The Atari goes into the VCR through coax, and then goes out through RCA component or RCA cable to this box. And then from this box, the HDMI will be going into an Elgato 60 capture card. And we'll just take a look. All right. So I've got this working here. This is in 16:9 widescreen mode for the Atari 7800 game, Pole Position 2. I'm now going to flip the switch to make it 4:3. Seems to be working pretty good there. Overall, the picture quality isn't bad. Alright, so here's a look at the 2600 game. Space Invaders. I like to use Space Invaders in general because it has a nice black background, so it's fairly easy to see any interference and what have you. I know what it's supposed to look like. And I know how it's supposed to respond. I am not noticing any lag. Now, there almost certainly is going to be at least a few milliseconds just inherent in the process, but I'm not actually seeing any. So the biggest issue these capture devices have is that there's a little bit of lag inherent in the process, whether it's lag through, this unit, maybe the VCR you're using. The Elgato capture card is generally lag-free, so it's not so much there. But all said and done, it can add enough milliseconds of delay that actually playing the games responsively can be difficult. I thankfully have not noticed that as an immediate issue on this one. I could tell a few milliseconds on my previous device that I had picked up a few years ago, and I did not notice that this time around. I've used this thing enough that I can usually spot a little bit of millisecond delay, although I'm not particularly sensitive to it. But in my experience, when I was hitting the buttons, it was firing as quickly as I would expect it to be able to play accurately. So I'm not saying there's no delay. There almost certainly is at least a few milliseconds inherent in the process, something like maybe 4 to 10. But I did not actually see a visible delay myself, nor did it impact my ability to play the game. Overall, though, the image is perfectly acceptable, and the response seems to be quite good. So I have to say I'm pretty impressed by this thing. It seems to be slightly nicer than the other cheap one I got a few years ago that did finally just stop working one day, which is why I bought this replacement. And the picture quality looks great for doing an old RF signal in through a VCR into a capture card through a $25 conversion device that I picked up off Amazon. And just because I could, here we have the Atari 7800 running through my VCR into the capture card, into the Elgato, through the Atari VCS, being captured in OBS in its original hardware. Like and subscribe if you would. Liking helps spread the word about the channel to others. And subscribing gets these videos in your feed. I'll have more news about the Atari VCS, the new one, along with all the great games coming out for it here in the coming weeks. Hope you're having a great summer, and I'll talk to you soon.